Hello, once again, to my studio with my Elektron gear for a gear demo. I guess that's what this is going to be. I've got with me here, as you can see, the Digitakt, my new best friend. I've also got with me the Octatrack over here, the analog heat over here, and up here, I've got the Roland System 1M. What I'm going to do today is mainly focus on the Digitakt and start something from scratch and sort of talk my way through it because I've had a bit more experience with it now and I feel like I can wrap my head around things a little bit more and talk about it with a bit more authority than I did before. but just to introduce this video, I've been working on for like say probably the past couple of years, I've sort of been casually working on a remix album. And I've just finished up work on a original album, which I'm going to be releasing very soon. So I'm sort of now diving in proper, like even more so to doing remixes for this other project. So I've just got a little quick remix here, which is just the beginnings of something. I haven't finished it or anything. But it's I've sampled the theme song from License to Kill, which is a Gladys Knight song from the James Bond movie from the 80s, Timothy Dalton. Not the best movie, but certainly a pretty great theme song. Very 80s. So let's have a quick listen to that, and then I will start fresh on something new. So anyway, you get the idea there. It's pretty, I really like that beat actually. I'll just mute everything else and, like on the kick drum. It's just a pretty straightforward kick drum, but I got some like reverse P-locks going and that's just a nice hi-hat with some weird shit going on with it, and this sound is being played chromatically, giving you. So, you know, anyway, that's just a little intro. Let's start a new pattern, shall we? I don't think I'll be using the Octatrack or the System 1 from this point forward. They were just to sort of demonstrate that other bit. I do have the analog heat over here. Maybe I'll fuck around with that. But at the moment, it's just set to clean boost. It's got a bit of drive. Everything else is pretty much flat. I just really like the warmth it gives to everything. Although, only the Digitakt is going through it. And actually, to demonstrate that, just real quick, go back to that beat. I'll just turn the active on and off and show you what I mean. So yeah, you know, you've seen my other videos, you know what this is about. So yeah, new pattern, let's do it. Nothing happening on this one, nothing at all. Everything else over here on the Octatrack is all muted and everything, so let's just get on with it. So this is primarily a drum machine. That's the way I'm looking at it at the moment. That's why I think most people looking at it, like, you can definitely do way more with it than just a drum machine. But the way it's set up is definitely tailored to sort of quick one-shot samples rather than really long extended pieces. Although you can totally do that. And I do have long extended samples in here, as I'll demonstrate right now. If I go right down to the bottom here, stuff I've recorded in myself. These ones I recorded from an app on my phone, which, you know, I used to have an iPhone, but now I've just got an Android phone. sorry, I'm coughing a lot. I recently quit smoking and everything's coming out of me. but yeah, it's basically, for, you know, Android apps have come a long way, and this one I think is really awesome. Especially the way you can play notes. It's got this sort of slider, so you can get some really nice kind of harp sort of sounds, as this sounds like right here. So if I go through the sample a bit. Oh, wait a second. There's that one, and then there's this one. I sort of chopped it up a bit, so there's this other one here. So, you know, that's an example of a longer sample, and the way I'm using it is not exactly like a drum machine. It's more like a sampler, which, of course, that's exactly what this is. But I guess what I'm saying is this, for one shots and stuff, this thing is just, like, beats just fall out of this thing. It sounds so pumping and rich, like, compared to the Octatrack, even though I love the Octatrack and it's a beautiful piece of kit, to get the same sort of level of punch and, like, just sort of ferocity, I feel like you've got to use the compressor that's on there, which, I mean, I do all the time, and that's part of the feature set, so of course you're going to use it, but this just kind of sounds punchy and intense right off the bat. And of course, you've got the overdrive here, which just crunches things even further. So I'm going to keep that sound because I think that sounds pretty sweet. So one thing that's interesting about this machine compared to a lot of other Elektron machines is the sort of the granularity of the sequencing. The Octatrack has the same thing, and to an extent the Analog 4 had the same thing as well. I can't speak to the rhythm because I haven't, or the rhythm because I haven't owned one of them, but I expect it's pretty similar as well, to be honest. But is the with the trigs, you can micro timing. So like when I played this in, I didn't quantize it, which has given it this kind of nice quality. Like, but what I might do real quick is change the tempo because it's a bit fast. And so when I've played the beat in, I just sort of played along with it, and that wasn't quantized either, but then I quantized it, and then now they don't quite match up so well because of the micro timing. So I'm going to go back to the second track, and I'm going to unquantize it because it's non-destructive. Like, it doesn't, once you quantize it, it's not like you can't go back. It's just this slider, and you can subtly quantize it if you want as well, so it's got more life, you know. In fact, you could do the exact same thing on the Analog 4. That's one of the good features of it. I'm just going to brush this dust off here. So with that in mind, let's try and get this in time. I won't speak for a little bit. I'll try and just sort of match this up. So it's not quite matched up, it's a bit off-grid, but I actually like the sort of the feel of that. It's kind of got a weird stuttery sort of feeling, and I'm going to amplify that. I'm going to exemplify, not exemplify, I'm going to highlight that to sort of try and give it some more organic flavor. So I'm going to go back to track one. Let's mute the other one just for a second. And before I do anything, I'm just going to copy the track so that I have an undo. I really, really wish Elektron machines would have a undo history. Like, that would just be so invaluable. The amount of times I've done, like, just a accidental button combination and completely lost a whole pattern. Like, it's happened enough times that I'm like, why don't you guys implement this feature? Maybe it's a memory limitation or something like that, but I don't care. Like, put that shit in there in your next machines. Make it so you've got an undo history rather than just one undo. Because, like, you can, like, if I clear, sequence cleared, if I press it again, undo pattern clear. So, like, there is an undo, but it only goes one step back. And that means if you go one more step after that accidentally, you're just totally fucked. So that's one, the problem with Elektron stuff that people don't talk about enough, I don't think. It's really easy to lose your work, given how sort of dynamic and on the fly and quite, I guess, improvisy the machines are. Maybe it's not the worst thing. Like, it, you know, you can just sort of create something again, but you shouldn't have to. If you get something really good going, you shouldn't have to lose it. So let's I've copied that track, and I'm going to do some live recording over it, and I'm going to do some, just tweak some stuff, and I'm going to get it more interesting. So let's do that. I'm not going to talk for a bit. Thank you. All right, so that's sort of taking shape, sort of carving out something from the chaos, which is a phrase I always like to use when referencing the Octatrack, but like Elektron stuff in general, is sort of finding the meaning in it all, you know? One thing I just wanted to touch on, though, is the real sensitivity of these knobs. Like, when I turn that, you just get incremental changes, and especially on the delay time, I find it really interesting because, I might actually record some of that in because I'm pretty sure I can parameter lock that. I don't know why I'm saying pretty sure. I'm almost certain I can. I don't know if I've tried it yet though. But the reason it's cool is because, like, you know, that's set to 24, but it's not exactly on 24. So it just gives it some movement. And I find that when I lock it to 24 or 32 or whatever, you know, you still get some interesting results, of course, but it's just a bit more static. And one thing I just love about this machine is just how organic it is. Like, even the Octatrack, which is very organic, I don't know, I don't want to shortchange the Octatrack, super organic as well. I just feel like this has some like, especially with, like, the trig conditions, you know, being able to make things that sound really evolving over time. Not even evolving, just changing, just dynamic. Without, you know, like a 64-step loop doesn't have to be always the same every time around, you know. And of course you can get similar results with LFOs and whatever on the Octatrack, like slow LFOs and stuff. This is sort of got it right built into its entire structure. It's like with trig conditions, with LFOs, with micro timing, with really subtle adjustments. Everything about it just screams like, let's make this as organic as possible. So I think this is sounding pretty cool. I might just save it real quick. And then I might try with the delay and just see, like, live recording in some delay timing changes and see if that works for a start, because the delay and the reverb are not track effects, they're you know, they're master effects. I'm not sure how that's going to work, but let's give it a try. I'm just going to mute these other two tracks because I only really want to do it on one. So, oh Jesus. Unfortunately, that doesn't seem to do anything. Maybe they can fix that in an update, because on other Elektron machines, like on the Analog 4, which has master effects, there's an effects sequencer, a whole track devoted to effect sequencing. I don't have my Analog 4 anymore, but that was one thing about it, which is really cool. So maybe they, and also on the Mono machine, you can do that kind of thing as well. So, you know, Elektron, in future, maybe try and update this to somehow make that work, because that would be really cool. But let's bring in these other tracks again. Got kind of an Autica thing going on here. Let's bring in some more melodic content. See if I can marry it up with this initial sound. Real quick, I really like this sample. It's part of the factory set. I just love that sample. it's so vaporwave, but it's just so, and I like vaporwave stuff, but oof, it's just so warm and fuzzy. It's just gives me the feels, you know. I also really like some of the other ones. Is it this one? Yeah, that one's really great too. But I've got some recorded stuff in here as well. So I recorded some piano in. fact, that's the first thing I sampled into this. So, it's a very long sample. I just want to use a really tiny chunk of it. Like, maybe like that one note there. So let's, listen to what this sounds like chromatically. I mean, that's cool, but I like the sort of just the single note hit. It's more less chaotic, more in keeping with the sort of glitchy atonal vibes of this. Thank you.
Thank you. Thank you.
great. Shit. I think that's pretty sweet. I think I'm going to leave it pretty much there. These last two tracks, they're sort of copies of each other, 6 and 7. They're both the same hi-hat sample, but one of them I've got a LFO running some sample tuning on it, and the other one I've got some sample panning on it, or some amp panning. And in addition to that, if I go to the trigs and go back to the source, I've got some forward looping, and then it sort of, so this trig and this trig both forward loop, so you get that stuttering effect on those two trigs. And you know, you get some pretty crazy results, actually. I mean, well, they're not madness results, but they're really nice. Like a slight phasing kind of effect between the two of them, and just that re-triggering, which it's still doing, is a cool effect. I'm still discovering new techniques. I just came up with that just then, just the idea of layering two different hi-hats on top of each other and doing that. This thing is just really dynamic and fun to use, so so I'm going to leave it there. What I'm going to play out with is some, I'm just going to save it, and then I'm going to play out with some control all, which you do by holding track and then just changing any of the knobs, and it just does those parameter changes to every single track, so you get some really crazy results. I might do some analog heat tweaking as well. So thanks for watching. I'm gonna play you out. Enjoy what you listen to. I hope you enjoyed me creating this. Let's do it. Let's go.